Wow. Just wow. Hey guys, from the Mind of Queen here, back again today with another movie review. Today we're talking Wonder Woman 1984. Let me start by saying, I loved the first Wonder Woman movie. It had great action, effects, and drama. Gal Gadot did an amazing job personifying Diana Prince. Chris Pine did an awesome job as Steve Trevor. The first movie did an incredible service to females everywhere by bringing a strong female into the spotlight. The sequel, Wonder Woman 1984, was different. For this review, I'm not gonna break it down into pros and cons. I'm just gonna talk about the film and points where I think it could be improved. This film revolves around a wannabe genie from Aladdin and Kristen Wiig as a literal translation of Michelle Pfeiffer's Catwoman. Throw in a side plot about Steve Trevor taking over some random dude's body and you got a bag full of what? I promise, I'm sober. At least we got more Wonder Woman. Only after just an hour and a half of soap opera level bullshit. We got the invisible plane though, for 5 seconds, but Wonder Woman now can fly? Suffice to say, this film was not what I expected. I couldn't really put a finger on this one. It was far too long. This movie was like 2.5 hours long, and that strikes me as odd, because I remember there being a rule in place saying no DC movie could be over 2 hours long, and this was 2.5 hours, and they spent it doing a lot of weird exposition and weird storytelling that kind of reminded you of the 90s Batman movies like Batman Forever, but also like Batman Returns. It kind of was way too drawn out. They could have condensed it a lot more. Another thing I didn't like about this movie was how slow it was. This movie took eons to get where it wanted to go, and even when it did, it was still very slow paced. This movie needed a little less talk and a lot more action, if you get my drift. Another thing I didn't get about this movie was some of the casting choices. Kristen Wiig is traditionally a comedic actress, and she shines in comedic roles. I didn't really get her as Cheetah. If maybe the Barbara character was funnier in the beginning, then this could work better. But it just kind of seemed kind of strange how she was portrayed as this, you know, awkward, shy, doesn't really have any funny lines, and then she's supposed to transform into this, you know, sexy goddess, and it doesn't really come off that great. And I think if they wanted to go with someone funny, then she would have been a great choice, but that really wasn't the character. And if they wanted to go with someone sexy, I would have chose someone different. Another thing I didn't like about this movie were the effects. Everything was way too bright, and it made it come off as almost like a Christopher Reeve thing. Now, I think that if this movie went down the same path as the Richard Donner Superman movies, that this tone would have fit. But between the colors and the effects themselves, like Wonder Woman's lasso, it just looked cheap in this film, and I didn't like it at all. Another thing I didn't get was, why was this set in 1984? I don't get it. This movie could have literally been in any time period, and they chose 1984. I don't get it. It doesn't drive towards the story. There's no significant events going on considering the 80s. Maybe the Cold War and all the missiles, but in reality, this could have been any generation, and I really don't get why they said it in 1984, because they didn't even really make too many 80s jokes, which would have been at least a little bit more entertaining. So what are my final thoughts on Wonder Woman 1984? Well, it wasn't great. I feel like this movie was a failure from conception. For a second, I thought they were going for a Richard Donner Superman thing, but nope, they were going for a strange superhero romantic comedy that wasn't funny. I don't know much about Cheetah, but I know they did that wrong. The main villain was a poor man's Lex Luthor, and he was very badly written. Just when I thought DC was getting its crap together, this happens. I actually prefer the Green Lantern movie. After the first Wonder Woman, I was really excited for this film. This sequel, however, was boring, overly long, full of cliches, and just plain weird. I give Wonder Woman 1984 a 0.5 out of 5. This has been From the Mind of Quentin. If you like this video, please subscribe and hit that notification bell. Also, make sure to like, comment, and share this video. Don't forget to follow me on Facebook and Instagram. Links will be in the description. And remember, folks, I'm From the Mind of Quentin, reminding you to always be mindful. Peace.